smarts to be combined, but I just want to say
I need your courage.
So, anyway, so...
You'll be fine, John.
Good evening, everyone. This is the August 1st, 2017 meeting of the Rollinsford Planning Board, and I think the, we have the first order of business would be approval of the June 2017 minutes.
I saw those on today. Those ones you sent to, I read those.
So I read them also. Is there a motion to accept those minutes? Or any, before, I guess I should say, are there any concerns about the minutes or corrections or... Is there a motion to accept those minutes?
I'll make that motion.
All right, is there a second?
I'll second.
All right, thank you.
You should vote.
Vote to, yes, let's have a vote. It's all in favor of accepting the June 2017 Planning Board meetings. Say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it. I think the, do we want to proceed next to things we want to move towards this year since we don't have an applicant?
That's on the agenda,
so.
You were the one that brought up the initial long-term goals.
It is.
Annual goals.
I am, and so I guess the one thing that sticks out to me is that I believe that our accessory dwelling ordinance does not conform to the state statute. And we probably need to amend that. I guess because my concern is if it doesn't conform to the statute, then...
The panel looked at this last year and determined that it did actually conform to the statute.
I thought it conformed enough that there is some ambiguity in it, though, which allows us to accept how the current standards are with the state. And I mean, we wouldn't rule against the state standards, and our I think our wording permits that we can agree with that. That's
okay,
how I thought.
So maybe I'm incorrect about that. I unfortunately
we can ask Mr. Kress to take a look at it, though. I mean, that's not
okay.
Best we say it.
The other thing that was like ongoing this past year was are we on the hook for producing any additional master plan chapters? Because you know that's been ongoing. I mean, I know the state requires certain things. Are we, in other words, is there a deadline before we have to produce a couple additional chapters? Do you know where that, and I know it's Mr. Krebs' question and not yours, I understand.
I'm not aware of a deadline, but we may be, yes. I think that the select board may have some recommendations also for changes to the master plan, or what to look at. We all would make the determination, but we're not ready to make those suggestions just yet. But probably next month.
But
so I mean,
isn't there also been?
Because I know, but.
But I know when we talked some of the original, very first preliminary master plan topics, those are some. Correct me if I'm wrong. 5, 6, 7 years ago, before we've had other developments, i.e., the Wentworth Road and self-storage units, and also now the Blumen property, and I mean, there's been significant changes to our initial chapters of the master plan. So I don't, and you know more about that.
I would think that we would want to. You know what? I think it ought to be best to do a review, in general review of the master plan, and see where we may be lacking in direction. I mean, like you said, we have had a number of projects, and there are other projects that could happen that we should probably try to be prepared for. So, you know, if we want to be strategic and actually plan on how growth develops in town, we want to be proactive in the master plan. So, yeah, maybe carve out some time next month. Also, before I forget, we need to, next month, we need to have a public hearing on the stormwater regulations that. Work on last year. We never
need
to have a formal, yeah, like a formal public hearing on it.
And do we need to do that as part of our planning board meeting or a separate meeting? Or
it
separate
could be
meeting?
Before. It could be during. I mean, you could have it just 7 to 7:15 or whatever. Yeah. And then the rest of the meeting could follow after that. But we do need to have it. So. We've been hoping to have this for a while now. So it needs to get on the agenda. So.
Okay. Absolutely.
Is there money allowed or out there or budgeted to pay Mr. Krebs for these services, is that something that we, so, okay.
It's part of his.
So not current, I mean, I think that the review of the older original ones that we did, yay, these many years ago.
We'll have to look and see how sort of deeply dive we wanted to do, but built in the scope of services is the review of the master plan, so.
And where, right now, Mike, would the master plan be accessed, can it be?
We have paper copies in the select board office.
Okay.
I've never seen electronic copies, but I know John Krebs has sections, I don't know if he has the whole thing. Because he did work on it, was it last year, the year before last, we did recreation, right, and historic. What was the other thing? Wasn't there three sections?
But he emailed the chapters for us to read, so eventually they are out there, they're just not assembled on the website.
I don't have it, it's on the website, I know.
It is on the website?
No, no, it's not, we would like to have it on eventually.
That costs money.
Have scan and broad, no.
So according to the New Hampshire
Association.
That's what I'm saying. You're required to have two segments. You have to have a vision chapter and a land use, but they recommend that you review every 10 years.
Okay.
You know, or as, but there's no RSA saying when you have to, other than the requirement of those two sections.
Okay. We have both those sections, I know that.
But I think that Mr. Macklin started this project many years ago.
Mm-hmm.
This was one of his goals, and he did very well with it.
I needed to find the copy of the most current master plan the other day for a meeting we were in. There are several. There were copies back to the 70s and 80s, so pretty easy to pass. So.
I know, so we had a discussion last time, or previously, about whether there wanted to be a perhaps a change to the zoning in regard to. You know, I always drive by site, I hate to say it, but Portland Ave across from Center Falls Potter, because wasn't there some discussion about changing that?
Rezoning.
To commercial. Although, when I personally drove that road, when thinking about that, the sight line isn't that great when you come over the top of the.
Right. But it's, you know, if you want to. You want to consider, I mean, we don't have to do it if you have a conversation. Maybe there are other parcels along Portland Avenue, not just the Oak Street parcel. I mean, I don't know if there are, but.
Okay, all right.
It's there or here in the village. So, not much else.
Okay.
Do we have to get the kitchen to do that by the owner, or can we do it ourselves?
I think we've been taking it on ourselves.
He's not required to change his current use at all, just the mill use has changed. More of it than it remains, it's just.
Gives you options.
Right.
If you want to do something.
They will put a comment out in for it.
There's nothing that we have to do, but we could have a conversation about whatever we need. And do a little business. So. I don't know enough about logistics, but.
I think there would have to be.
Give an answer, yes or no.
Of what would look and fit because of. That road and that bridge.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It would have to be an industrial use that doesn't have any trucks greater than 6 tons.
Yeah.
They all have to dump out onto Mr. Mike's street.
Right, right.
And it's a lot of traffic. And if you talk industrial with box trucks or.
Depending on what.
Depending
on the
a commercial use using these commercial uses.
Last year, one of the biggest trials we had, of course, was the development on Clement Road. And there was some discussion last year about whether or not we wanted to, and I think it's mixed feelings on the board, as to whether we wanted to change the permitted uses for, I believe that is in SR1.
The duplexes.
The duplexes. Yeah. As to whether or not we want to revisit that. I've gone by there a couple times, I haven't gone in, and I don't really see any work that's being done there, interestingly enough.
I think
so.
You can see the remnants of the original, of the road that was used to access it.
Yeah, that's, but it's not to this point.
There's nothing before the board, I can say at this point. Other than they've been approved for certain uses.
Is there any feeling whether I want to, you want to change that or continue with that use?
As a suggestion, where you talked about, the point of this discussion was like a year plan, I think.
Right.
Layout like a year plan, and I think, you know, John would want to be involved in that.
Okay.
This is something I think we'd want to get his input on as well as.
Sure.
So I think you could decide, you know, you can give us a, if there's nothing on the agenda next month, or 2 months out, that we could actually plan some time with John, have him review, so he could present with us, okay, here's where we're at, instead of, okay, I'll take a look at it, you know, maybe give him a heads up, or next month, tell him to have it for the fall. I mean, however you want to lay it out, or you want to leave those.
Sure.
Plotting to Miles, I just supported your opinion that we should have a year-long goal.
Sure, okay.
I support that.
So, all right, and so do we need to make a formal motion to have John look into that, or we can just memorialize that in our minutes?
Into the issue of
I guess changing
or
right on
or more. I'm sorry, I was thinking about
I guess with the permitted uses for SR1 in terms of duplexes and greater than duplexes.
It's not, it's also SR1, right?
I think it's SR1 and 2. And
so two family dwellings are allowed in urban residential,
SR1,
SR1, SR2,
country
residential, mills, and forestry. So if we were looking at it, I would think we'd want to look at every zone. It doesn't make sense that it stays in the mills and forestry. Yes. But it doesn't make sense for country residential, it makes sense for urban residential, or the pros and cons, it would be more like a peak of them, to be honest. So.
Okay.
Right, I mean, because that's, yeah, single family residences are allowed in all districts, except for commercial. They aren't even permitted in them. But let's see, multiple families are only allowed in certain zones now, so. So this was really the bone of contention, right? That drove people out even more when they found out, at least for this one development on Clement, that's the possibilities. So. I would just stick to that.
Okay.
I think that that's maybe something that we discuss at the next meeting with John attends.
Yeah.
And maybe lay it out in a 2 or 3 month scope as to, you know, where we can discuss that and what goals we'd like to have for the following year, make suggest, you know, this coming year for master planning and or zoning changes with John.
So as chair, I can't make a motion myself, but that'd be, I can't.
No, I think you can just say you want to table it until
so Mr. Krebs attends. Yeah, we can do that.
Okay. The other concern I had in regard to that whole Clement Road issue is, and I don't know whether there are more updated guides, but the sight line and the speed. Mm-hmm. I guess I was concerned that, unfortunately I can't find it in the what I'm looking for tonight, but that the sight line distance takes no, as I recall, nothing in consideration regard to the speed on the road, which to me is counterintuitive.
What do we need to review then that section as well?
If that is up to date or not.
Right.
Because I think it makes a big difference as to whether or not you're able to see traffic in time. And if there is going to be future development along there.
Just like some of these standards, these are, you know, state established safety standards. And same thing with a lot of the discussion we had about that particular Clement Road development was that when those plans were presented to us, they were already an engineered plan.
They're national standards.
Well, even greater extent, but that's what I mean, is those plans that came to us and went through several reviews, those are plans that, you know, a licensed, educated individual that knows about sightline and plans and speed, you know, looks at. Right? Because it could never come as far as it, I mean, it'd be shut down very quickly. And I know that the public's concerned about that, I agree with it, it's, but those are, as you corrected me, national standards for safety.
And they were reviewed by our consulting engineer.
Even still.
And so, what we're saying then, or Chris, what you're saying, Kevin, is that the standards in our regulations, our ordinances, are up to date, that they aren't.
I don't know that to be interesting. I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, it could reference, I would, we should never assume, I would guess that they probably reference national standards. But as we found in a few other places, 2 years ago, I think it was, Tom Clark, who's your building inspector, suggested making some reference changes because they were outdated. They're outdated references, really.
Because they cited specific references.
Right, that no longer exists. So
I guess it would be a good check to make sure our language states something to the effect of current or nationally accepted or or most current standards as exists.
Right, because it refers the BOCA National Building Code. Tom said it's extinct, so we probably should just reference state building code just to be safe and whatever the state is using.
And that makes it safe because you're not quoting a specific.
So I don't know, honestly, so if that's what it
might be a good idea.
A review of that might be
a good idea.
Because if I recall correctly, too, about the public concern, now I'm thinking more back about it, was that the residents were concerned that, yeah, and I believe part of the answer was the police department isn't enforcing it, is that people are not obeying the speed limit anyways on Clement Road, and that it's unsafe to walk on Clement Road as it presently is, or residents feel that it presents a significant danger.
Residents' perception may be that the police aren't enforcing it, but I see people pulled over on that road all the time. So.
And you have to add some, you have to factor in some, perhaps if I was a resident there, I might not want this to happen either. And unfortunately, regardless, if it's been determined that it's a safe, acceptable standard that this is being put in, and this gentleman wants to develop his land and his investment, he has every right to. Not to say that I wouldn't voice my opinion, but nonetheless, anything that comes up for us to that degree has already been reviewed to a certain extent. No one's going to show up with something that'll never fly.
Well, I don't know if that's true.
Well, and so some of the focus you get from residents and or abutters will be that concerned because of.
Oh, for sure. Feelings. I think that.
And I understand that.
Their view is colored in that sense. You know, they may not want it just on the street. But I don't know if it's accurate to say that every plan that comes before us is necessarily
well vetted.
So, but anyways.
Did anyone go and take a look, and maybe this isn't properly on the agenda, to take a look at the road in the Scoutland development?
I sure did.
And that is somewhat unusual with the it's not Scoutland, it's
Oh, well, I can give an update about that afterwards if you want.
Sure.
We have our guests here.
Okay, sure. Yeah, sorry. Right. Forgive me for losing
my answer for
let's,
you.
So
I'll make a note so we don't forget.
Please come forward. I apologize for getting distracted and not.
No, yeah, well, obviously, I was late. So I
no, 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 it's my fault, but I apologize. And please give us your name and.
Can I put the board up here? Is that all right?
Yeah, we have an easel for it.
Oh, you do? Oh, yeah. I couldn't find mine, so. Or I could just stick it on this. That would be a chair. Yeah, you know, just white. I can put it on this chair.
Okay.
Yeah. The plans are going to, you know, change anyway, so. But yeah, my name is Jack Apsey, and I purchased the Woolen building, and we're currently renovating it.
What's the address of that?
710 Main Street.
And it's
APSEY? Yes.
Okay. And 710 Main
Street. You got that right. So right now we're proposing to change the use of the upper floors into residential, and the lower floors would stay commercial. So this is the street view right now as you drive down Main Street. So this, these three floors would stay commercial. And the way that the ordinance is written, they allow residential on the upper, you know, if the ground level is commercial. So this actually, the plan's gonna change a little because what we're proposing to do is lower the site a little bit, just to make it a little bit more kind of open to the street and get like a higher ceiling height. And then put glass in the front to kind of with entrances, you know, to invite people in. So this part here would actually go down, and these would be, you know, individual like entrances with glass. So that would be the commercial part of it, just to kind of make this more like part of downtown, like retail or, you know, restaurant, whatever the use would be. This is a proposed addition for access. It's a stairwell. So this would be on the left side as you look at the front of the building. And this would just become a stairwell for people to get to these apartments. The entrance to this would be on the other side. And this is just a door, an additional door for people that want to access the commercial part. Change a little bit, but that would be the new, so this would be a new structure that we're proposing.
This is from the back view?
This is from the railroad
yeah.
side, if you're at the railroad. So now this becomes the ground level. So we were going to keep a couple of bay doors just because it's still commercial use. This bay door will probably go away, and this will be glass. This unit becomes actually a handicapped apartment, because this entrance will now be handicapped accessible, because right now the building's not ADA accessible. So we'll be making this whole floor ADA accessible with a public ADA bath and an ADA apartment. And this would be an ADA ramp.
From the front of the building, it's a six-story building.
Right.
From the back, it's
four.
Yep. So the first two are...
So this would be all residential. The top three, and then this would be all commercial, but the building requirement is you need to, every use that's in the building needs an ADA use, so we would just add the ADA apartment on that floor since that's ADA accessible. So that's the only reason there's one unit being proposed on that floor, just for anybody with a wheelchair, they would have the ability to rent that unit.
Sorry to interrupt again, but
yeah.
So the bottom two floors are commercial or the bottom three?
Probably bottom three.
Bottom three.
Yeah, because the two here, the two here would stay commercial. And then when you go to the back, this is the third. It's technically not the ground level, but if you drive to the back, it is the ground level, kind of. You know, it's almost like a split level, because you can actually, there's actually a bank of windows here that you look down into the second floor. So
the lowest level in the back is the third level in the front.
Exactly. Yeah. So now this may be like...
It's on a hill, so.
Yeah, it's on a hill. So this, I don't know if you call that ground level or not, but you're on the back of the hill now, so... What we did is we kept it commercial to try to stay with the spirit of the ordinance, but we just put a one apartment in there just to make it ADA compliant, because that's what the building requirements are. You know, when you do a mixed use building, that's just to meet the building requirements. So again, this is pretty much what the building looks like now. This would be the only addition. And, you know, at the next meeting, we'll have a full site plan. so we'll have all the parking and, you know, we'll have elevations.
The number of units you're proposing, rental units too?
The apartments are gonna be 19.
Are they gonna be one bedroom, two bedroom, three bedroom?
One bedrooms.
One, 19 one bedrooms?
Yeah, because we'd have six per floor, we've got three floors, and then we'd have the one handicap.
And how many business units left bottom on commercial space, is that, I mean?
Well, you know, we really haven't split them up, so I don't think that's an issue, but I think it's an open floor plan now, but there might be, I think the way the architect drew it, there's like some small offices on the third floor, but I think the second and first floors are just open. Because it's kind of the way they are now, because it was rented, it was one tenant occupied it. So it wasn't really split up, it was pretty much, you know, they had, there was one unit, really, technically, you know, kind of purchased it, so. But this is a, more of a floor plan. So this is what you'd be looking at, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, one bedrooms. I think the ordinance, the way it was written, was two bedroom or less.
Yeah, it says.
Two bedroom or less.
Can have no more than two bedrooms per unit, two parking spaces allocated per unit.
Yeah.
But then for multi-use in that district, we have to go back and look if you can have as many as 19, I don't know.
I don't think there was a density requirement. I was trying to think what the limitations were, quantity of units that was in the
I apologize, our consultant's not available this evening. He's out of the country.
Is there an elevator?
There's a freight elevator, but no, there's no passenger elevator. That's why we put the new entrance here. So all the residential tenants would enter from here, so we don't have to go up maximum 3 foot stairs. And it's a new stairwell, that's a new built to code. Because obviously the stairwell in there now is like the old mill stairwell, so it's not up to code. So this would all be like a code compliant stairwell. But there is a freight elevator that actually works in the building.
Just a question. You said you're gonna alter the grade of the front area. Can you tell me what the surface is of the front area right now? Is it broken asphalt?
It's all asphalt. Yeah.
Is it completely, you know, hazed in, or is it intact?
Yeah.
It's intact.
Yep.
And are you proposing? Has there been any decisions made as far as finished surfaces on the front and rear parking areas?
Well, the rear parking area would become asphalt. Right now, it's gravel. But that obviously that'll be fully all the drainage will be done and taken care of. So you know, full site plan on the back. The front we haven't decided if we're gonna expand the parking.
Where does the water from the front collect the indoor drain currently?
Right now I think it goes right down the road. Dumps right out under the roof.
It gets graded to come out the actual entryway and then
a lot of it. Some of it actually goes to towards the downhill side of Main Street, but then it runs along the property line and it dumps down onto that front landscaped area.
It's gonna do what it's gonna do, I realize that, yeah.
Yeah,
they
didn't do
it.
There's no control of any drainage over there at this point. I mean, it's an old, you know, they didn't do anything, so. So obviously if the engineer looks at that front area, he'd deal with that runoff. But the way, you know, usually most towns, the way they address that is if you're increasing the runoff, then you have to deal with it. But if you're not increasing the runoff, then you technically don't have to add the drainage, water retention. Obviously on the back, we're paving, so that'll be, you know, done to full specifications.
That's always been just gravel and dirt.
Yeah.
That's what
So actually, I think it's like, actually, pavement only increases runoff like by 10% or something. It doesn't increase as much as you think. But because we're doing that, obviously, the engineer will deal with that. And then on this site plan, I'm not sure what he's doing on the front, if he's even gonna deal with that right now. We might actually submit that later. Because right now, we're just trying to get the apartments completed.
Right.
And then the lot in the back, because the lot in the back will have all the parking to serve the apartments. So there'll be the two spaces. So you'll have a minimum of 38 spots in the back. But then if you add the commercial.
That's the front.
Well, no, the third floor is also commercial, so it'll probably just put like 50 spots in the back.
And you'd have, I mean,
I think I could do 70 back there.
Even with the, the solar farm is still parking.
Right,
I know it's big out there.
Yeah, I think I could fit 70 spots right now.
Okay.
But I don't think he's gonna do that. But you'd have all the residential spots and probably all the third floor commercial spots in that back lot. And then the front lot, we would try to make it address the first two floors, but we'll have to take a look at that.
Right.
He might just do the whole thing. I gotta sit down and figure it out, but he might just do the whole thing. It's just, I don't know if we're gonna have time to get to that front parking lot. So I don't know if I wanna do the engineering on it now, but
I understand you have still some big decisions ahead of you. I understand that's a lot,
So if I'm trying to compartmentalize it, like right now I'm trying to deal with the residential. So like the addition that we proposed, that's to service the residential part of the building.
Right.
And
it's not the full width of the building, I see. It's just basically...
Yeah, it's basically a stairwell.
Just to house the stairwell itself.
Yeah, and then we actually put this in here for future elevator, if that ever we ever wanted to add that. It's just, it'll be a dead space. And then they're going to build a handicap ramp, to the building, which it doesn't have right now.
Right.
So
I'm sure your engineer's been looking at all of our zoning requirements.
Yes.
As he goes along.
Yeah, they'll make sure everything's compliant.
Okay.
I'm hoping to have him get that done by September 1st, so that you, because I know that's really what you guys focus on is the site plan. So.
The access to the parking out back, for someone to park a lot out back, someone drives on the front of the building to leave, is that right? Or how do people...
For the parking lot out back, you go up Railroad Ave.
Okay, you can go problem there.
Yep, that's how it is right now.
Okay. That's the only way to get back. That's the only
right.
Way.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, you could if I put a road in, but...
No, I'm just trying to think of where that...
Yeah.
It has a two-way town recognized.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's actually a pretty good access.
Some addresses. Yeah, there's a people live on that.
Yeah, there's actually a couple. Yeah, there's three residential homes on that street.
Okay.
So if you're really considering changing the topography out front and lowering, I would suggest that part of your overall plan. That's a major part of the site changing.
Right, well, what I would do is I would make sure that I gave myself enough parking in the back to cover me if I didn't increase the front.
Okay.
But I'm going to see if it's not out of control, I might just have them do the whole thing. You know what I mean? Because what do I have, like 2 years to complete it or something? Is it two years?
For those, I think.
On an approved site plan?
I think it is.
It's usually two, but
I'm sure you understand that we use Mr. Krebs for a lot of our consulting reviews of plans. And ideally in everyone's best interest, in yours as well, getting him some sort of plans to at least start reviewing, because he's been very helpful in guiding. He's been a very big asset to the board. He's a good, John's very smart of how the town.
Right. Well, if you want, I can because I know where his job trailer is. If you want, I can drop a set of plans off.
I'm not trying to waste any bounds. I think it would help you as well as just keep the ball going.
Well,
timeliness is of importance.
When you make the formal application and send it in, it gets forwarded right away.
So we're good then. All right, awesome. Yeah, I'm trying to get this thing put together by the 1st so that you guys can have some time to look at it. And then I'm trying to do a public hearing on first of October, right? That would be, because you'd probably.
So you're hoping to get on the October.
Well, you probably want some time to review it right before a public hearing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, so my goal is to get you guys a completed site plan by September 1st.
Okay.
Then you have the whole month to look at it. We can go back and forth if we need to, and then I'm trying to do a public meeting on the 1st. Because I'm getting into my winter, you know, I gotta get stuff done, and obviously,
right.
Construction, I gotta get stuff done in the fall.
Mm-hmm.
You know, especially if it's site related stuff.
Right.
So, I'm kind of like, it's, you know, that's, I'm on a timeline, so I'm hoping if I'm complete by the 1st, you guys would have enough time and then go to, you know, go to a public meeting on the 1st, if possible.
Of October?
That's my goal, yeah, 1st of October for a public meeting. But yeah, if you could look up the apartment.
The meetings on October.
Okay. That would be awesome, yeah. If I could get. If the engineer gets everything done by the 1st, then you guys would all get a copy. Right, because. Could I give you a copy after the meeting, or do you need to get it at that meeting?
No, you send it, you submit it, and then we distribute it.
Okay.
Can you send it as a PDF so that we can
That'd be perfect. Yeah, I can get you a digital copy,
yeah.
Yeah,
so if you send it to me, then I'll
Okay, great. So then everybody might even get it before the meeting?
Yeah,
on the 1st.
I think I have your
Yeah, Carolyn's got it.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you don't have it.
I think I have it too. So.
Okay. Well, yeah, that would be sweet if you guys get it all done before the 1st, and you guys have a little time even before the meeting, you know?
Yeah.
In terms of the driveway going into the building, and I walk by there all the time, but I can't think of the sign. Is it wide enough so that two cars can, a car can be leaving and entering at the same time?
Right now it is, yeah.
Okay.
But it is on a hill, and if you look at it, when you drive by there, look at it. It's kind of high, and that's the other thing, you mentioned it. By being so high, it's really dumping a lot of the water into the road. So actually, technically, if I lower it, it might actually now contain more of the water, and then I can slow it down before it hits the road, you know what I mean?
It is an odd setup that you're currently dealing with, that's right. You cross, you kind of cross,
and I'm
the,
on a hill.
Cross the sidewalk, and then go up a little knoll, and then you're in the parking lot.
Yeah.
It's tough, yeah, I get
yeah,
that.
It's a weird spot, but
you also got a banking that runs as the side, as the road descends, you've got a banking as well that.
Oh, I know.
There was a lot of shrubbery on in years past.
Yeah, that was pretty unsightly. Yeah, I was trying to mitigate that.
It looks
too,
better. It looks much better.
Yeah, so we're going to do something with that, obviously, to make it prettier, but the only thing I got going for me is there's a drain right there. So, like, if the water went out my road, it only goes down, like, maybe 16 feet, and it hits that drain. So it's not, like, careening down the hill. It's going to hit that drain, which is good, and then I got to talk to the highway department about tie-ins and how they work that, because I'd rather just hard pipe it to that drain, ultimately, but the engineer, you know, will probably deal with that.
Now, currently, sewerage for your building right now, you're on the town sewage system.
Yeah. Yeah, it was
for sewage,
and it was one unit. That's how they had it listed.
Have you had any conversations with the water and sewer district?
Oh, yeah. I got to write them a big fat check.
But they've given their blessing to that many units?
They have no problem with, yeah, they have the capacity. I met the engineer was actually at the meeting with me.
Okay.
So I met with the directors and the engineer, and the engineer said the capacity is not an issue whatsoever.
Okay.
It's just the fee that we're going back and forth on, because that's, you know, I'm not building 19 houses.
Mm-hmm.
They're 19 one-bedroom apartments, so I'm trying to keep it to a minimum, you know, to make the impact as low as I can. So that's really where I'm coming from is I don't have, you know, it's not like I'm building a four-bedroom house with four kids and, you know, guests coming over. So that's where we're at right now, but yeah, they're aware of it, and I didn't hear any feedback from them, negative feedback about the impact as far as our capacity.
Okay.
But they said they're waiting for my plans, basically.
Right.
You know, and they want to see what I'm actually doing, so.
In terms of lighting, any early thoughts on if you're gonna be seeking to install additional lighting or?
Well, the building is so massive that I was thinking about just using the building for lighting, if I can come up with some good solutions and, you know, maybe light the parking areas from the building. But I'm open to suggestions on that. I mean, it towers, I think I'm 55 feet on this side, and on the other side, I think I'm like 35 feet. So.
My only thoughts would be there's a lot of residential units around there that, to the extent that there could be prevention of too much, you know, light entering into some of those, you know, the surrounding.
Are there floodlights on the front now?
There were, but I took them down.
Right, but they were before.
Yeah, they were kind of obnoxious, so I took them down. I actually had to hook up my floodlights in the back because I had some vandalism and damage. So I had to put those up for security in the back. But on the front, I took them down because they had like one weird halogen light right over the door, which was pretty ghetto. So, yeah, if I had to put a couple nice lights out on the edge of the lot facing in, you know, that's cool. Whatever. I don't know what your requirements are.
We have a section on lighting ready.
Okay.
Too, that your engineer can take.
Yeah, he'll take a look at that and figure something out. Oh yeah, I'd like to do the whole site if you can. That would be nice for him to put the whole package together. And I'll try to see if we can address that.
I know Mr. Krebs will want to see landscaping included as part of the site plan.
Yeah, we'll put that on there.
Okay.
Totally. Yep.
All right.
Are there landscape requirements in the ordinance?
Are to the extent where we want to. Not a fringe upon the neighbors, that sort of thing. Let's see. I got the right one. Okay. Fortunately, these don't have an index, so I have to give you a moment to find it for you.
Okay.
Table sections.
From the existing left side of the building over the property line, the side you're proposing for the.
Yep.
What's your distance to your lot?
Right now I got about 50 feet.
And what's that consist of? Is it grass? Is it shrubs? Is it trees? Is it gravel?
It's all cleared.
Okay.
Yeah, the property line has some big maples on it.
But that's farther back.
The property line at 50 feet has big maples on it.
Okay.
So there's a 50 feet of basically open area.
And what's the dimension out from the building that?
That's probably going to be 18 feet.
So you're still 30.
I think it's 15 inside setback. So
I don't remember that zone, but yeah.
Yeah, it's 15. So I'm good on my setback.
Okay.
And obviously I'd like to keep those maples if I could. They're nice, like big old maples. So those would stay here. I don't have an abutter there. It's actually mid-construction that owns the water tower lot.
Oh, yeah.
Huh.
So
it's
actually
the very
no,
next lot, right? Okay.
Yeah. So there's actually no, technically no abutter right there. There's a home down, you know, on the road. Yeah, so fortunately, I don't think I need any variances. I guess I could talk to maybe Tom about it, or maybe you guys could answer this question. Here, would be the only I was proposing. This is the back of the site. You know, the back lot.
Yeah.
I was proposing to put a fire door here because this is the stairwell right now is in this column. They wanted some egress for fire escape. But this actually, if I put this egress deck up, it wouldn't make the setback. So what I was proposing is just to put some knee braces down in the building so that there's no actual structure down to the ground within the setback.
The rear setback or the side setback?
This would be a
the
side
rear setback. But you're not coming out any further than the dimension of the building, so your side setback isn't changing.
Well, no, this is actually a deck because you're looking straight on. If you look from the side, I don't know if she drew it, she probably didn't draw it.
Did she draw it?
I don't know. If you look from the side, this sticks out, this is a deck, a landing.
It sticks out towards the rear of the building, not to the side.
Well, no, because actually, yeah, without the site plan, it's going to be hard for you to see, but there's actually the lot jogs in.
All right, okay.
It's weird.
That means
it jogs in along, and
so it's still a rear setback that you have an issue with, because your
rear
lot line is...
It's not
going to
make the setback. So basically, that's the only... We just wanted to do that for a safety standpoint. So I think it would be a big positive thing, but technically, that little landing wouldn't be in the setback, and I would put 45s on it, so it wouldn't actually be a structure out within the setback, but the actual projection of the landing would be, and then the stair down would be in the setback. So I guess that would be my only potential, because I could take that out off the plan, but we kind of thought that would be, would make the building inspector happy if we didn't have that option.
I think it's a great idea. Just, I mean, there could be discussion on that. I mean, it's a safety, very positive safety factor, so.
Yeah, I mean, I'll have to keep it on the plan. You guys.
But John would be good to advise
okay.
on that, because I'd be very pro that idea.
So section 12 covers landscaping, and section 9 covers lighting, so those would be two areas they'd want to.
Okay, so then, yeah, it would be so 9 and 12.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, I'll have them put all the land, the proposed landscaping on the site plan. So you guys will have everything to look at.
Perfect.
That would be great. Have everything.
So is it the first? The September 1st? Is that the next meeting?
It's the first Tuesday in September.
Oh.
What's the date?
It's the 5th.
Oh, it's the 5th?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's the day after Labor Day.
Oh, all right. Yeah, I won't be here that day, but maybe I can just have somebody come.
Well, you're just submitting the plans, right, for them? You want
just
to be on, you want to be on the agenda? You can email them in. You don't have to physically come and bring.
Oh, okay. Maybe I'll do that because I want to get on the docket for the October 1st for the public hearing. But if I don't have to be here, I'll just give you guys the plans.
And
okay, that
will
cool.
give us, I mean, you'll send them in to Sarah.
Yeah.
And she'll distribute them to John and to us.
Yeah.
He'll do his review, and so we'll be ready to go for October. And if there are things that are missing, he can tell you. You know, you need to have these other things. Right?
Okay,
so,
yeah, and then I can just have the engineer make
those
changes.
And then it would be October 3rd would be the...
Right, the
meeting.
Public hearing, yeah. So that would be, ideal. If it all works out that way, that would be excellent just for my scheduling.
Yeah, I mean, you just have to have everything in by, like, the 22nd in order for
of
me
August.
To... Of October. In order for me to notice... Oh, I'm sorry.
Just September.
I'm just trying to figure out...
Oh, for the public hearing, you mean?
Yeah, the 22nd of September.
Okay. I don't think that's an issue.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be easy to do.
So that's like your fees, your letter list, all that stuff.
Right.
But it's
okay.
in the plans before, so.
Yeah, and you'll already
especially
have the plans.
Yeah.
So if I get you guys the plans by the meeting on the 1st, will you discuss the plans at the meeting?
No.
Oh, okay, so you just discuss them like privately?
No, John Krebs will review them, and then we'll on the 3rd of October.
On the 3rd.
We would have the you would do your presentation. We'd have the public hearing, and then we would go through Mr. Krebs' list of concerns. So
So that happens at the public hearing.
Yeah, it would be very unusual to get approval, especially a project this size, the same night. I wouldn't think you would have approval until the very earliest November if you wanted to do it that way.
Right. Okay. So yeah, because that was my question. Because you guys really can't review it then to propose changes until the actual public hearing.
Correct.
Okay. So yeah, unfortunately, I think we'd have to wait then. So I would only ask for the approval on the 1st. I would need to make the amendments, and we need to review it over that month period. So.
And we could if the plan is indeed complete on October 3rd, we can certify it as complete, accept it as complete that night, and then there could be conditions that have to be met. But it would be very unusual for
vote
for our town,
right?
Only because we don't have full time. planning staff, that other communities have, volunteers, so, to get it all together.
Right, because you need time to look at that and go back and forth. That makes sense.
And we only meet once a month too, so we don't, you know, in some towns where they might meet twice a month, but we meet some places.
Right.
We're not like that, unfortunately, so.
Okay. Yeah, well, hopefully it's like a really mild fall and we have Indian summer. Doesn't snow.
They go later.
You never know.
Okay, so.
Thank you for this.
Yeah, thank you for coming in.
All right.
Look forward to seeing the final plan.
Good for now.
I think we're good, Alan.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, man. What's that?
We discussed the goal for the year, which was on the agenda. I mean, this was the first item and the goal was the second, and I think correspondence. We did minutes already, correspondence.
I don't know where, I'm not aware of any correspondence. Was it made aware of things?
I think that was about everything.
So, but for next meeting, I have one thing to talk about. For next meeting, we'll make sure that the public hearing is on the agenda for the stormwater rates.
Yes.
For site plan.
Yeah, you said Carolyn had that information?
She does.
Okay, so we need to grab that from her and then get it.
She does.
You mentioned,
you had a question.
The berms added on, what was it?
Yes, so we asked Mr. Clark to look into it. He went up and spoke to site manager, with Chinberg. It's not a town accepted road yet. We don't plow it, we don't maintain it as of yet. They're leaving them on until they put the final coat of pavement on.
Finish grade.
Right. And then it's not, the road is not complete yet. And at that time, they won't be necessary because the road will be up high enough. They understand that those are something that can stay. They're
purely
temporary until the road is complete. So, and we don't have possession of the road, so we're fine.
It's still under construction, and it's permitted construction, so it's...
So, but they understand completely that that can't happen. But they also said it wouldn't be necessary, because the road would be high enough where it would be an issue with the upper end. So, yes. It was a happier answer than I thought we were going to have to worry about, so...
So a motion to adjourn?
I'll make that motion.
Second.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
See you all next month.